Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the action. We are coming to you live from Hasselt, Belgium! For the second round of the Unibet European Darts Championship, brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation, live on ITV Sport. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the millions of viewers joining us around the world, it's time to meet the players. Ladies and gentlemen, a winner of a PDC ranking event, it's time to meet the ferret, Johnny Clayton! Gentlemen, and now it's time to meet the winner of the UK Open and German Masters. Let's get this party started!
In the commentary box for us, Alan and Stuart.
Well, beat that. Alan and I had struggled. A real showman. Fantastic darts player. And one of the true big characters of the wide world of darts. Loving every minute of it. The crowd love him. Wherever you go around the world watching darts, there are lots, and I mean lots, of Mohican wigs in the audience. Big Christoph Rutajski in the opening round, and getting the crowd involved. They love him around the world, but my, in Europe, he is so popular. Look at this! Well, the ferret can only smile, Johnny Clayton. A terrific performance, 103 average in beating Dimitri Vandenberg to lay down a marker, and he's in the form of his life. And Peter Wright will have to be on his best behaviour, I think, against the Welshman, but Wright will be well aware of what Clayton can offer.
Yes, Peter Wright is definitely now the real deal in terms of his all-round game. And Clayton, a relative newcomer. That's a very big test here. He's enjoying himself. He's having the time of his life up there on the hockey at the moment, playing well.
Well, he's taking advantage as well, isn't he, Johnny Clayton? Incredible to think that he just made it through to the European Championship. 32 qualifiers on the Euro Tour Order of Merit, and he got the very last spot. It was level on, order on, money earned with James Wilson, the Yorkshireman, but on count back, Clayton got here by virtue of reaching the last 16 of the last Euro Tour event. 16. Well, he's taking advantage.
Alexander Wright. now there's quite a few people sweating. That last European Tour event was on, Stuart, going into it. A few of them who are currently in position hadn't qualified. That's all history now. Clayton earned his right in his first game.
95.
Fantastic performance against Dimitri Vandenberg, 6-1. Tom plus average as well. This lad can play, trust me.
He's playing all right in this opening leg. Real pressure on Peter Wright from the Welshman. Get to settle in here.
16.
The number two seed.
It is a tall order for Clayton. If he can manage a win here, we'll go up to number 38, Stuart. So many players hovering around that 32 spot. Heading to the World Championships. He played in the World Championships last year, didn't he? Big Kevin Price in the first round.
100.
He's in a better position this year to qualify. Number one from all the 16 after the 32 have been taken out.
Oh, good leg. 14 darter to break the throw for Johnny Clayton. Peter Wright knows he has a game on here. Winner, of course, to play Daryl Gurney in the quarterfinals. This is amazing. What a start. That's 3 140s already for Clayton.
Well, there's certainly no nerves there, Stuart. So Peter Wright probably knew it anyway. The Senate had it reinforced. He's got a tough game on here.
Found his range, hasn't he? Early on, Clayton. Ferret. Fantastic nickname.
It just shows you what confidence can bring when you win a players' championship. He's won it. And a big group of players, Stuart, as you know, who are playing well, are just looking to try and get that breakthrough. Won a players' championship. He's had a pretty good season overall, qualified for a lot of European Tour events. There's Peter Wright.
Much needed as well.
Yeah, fires in that one, and he needed it, like you say, Stuart, because he may have to take out this 137.
Giving himself a chance. Can he follow a maximum with a fantastic finish?
Can't do it now. There's another chance for Clayton. 61. Show of 15 or the 25. Oh. Is it the 18?
Two out of two on the doubles. Two legs to nil to Johnny Clayton. Yeah, that players' championship win came just a fortnight ago, and we were talking about him knocking James Wilson out of contention for the European Championship. Wilson will be sick of the sight of the Welshman, because it was Wilson who Clayton beat in that final, 6-1. What a day to remember, his maiden PDC title. Yes, showing here against Peter Wright exactly why he won on that day.
Yes, I was there on that day in Barnsley.
81.
Just that final, played terrific in the semi-finals and final, but some of the early matches when he was having a couple of 6-5s and just did enough.
Important leg this for Peter Wright, got a whole throw, that'll help. Can't afford to go 3-0 down, I don't think. Two breaks of throw down, but no fear. Clayton is just going up there and continuing, it seems, where he left off against Vandenberg and where he left off against Wilson in that final in Barnsley. Full of confidence.
16.
Can take advantage here, all right. Another treble.
Back to back. Lee Shanghai. Again, Peter Wright. Thinking in his mind, he's going to have to take this. And he's given himself the chance. Tops!
Oh, fantastic effort. Will it be in vain for Peter Wright? Leaves the treble.
100.
Gotta go now. Get a leg on the board. Ooh. Ooh. Wow. Four missed darts at double. I'm sure Clayton didn't expect to be coming back. Can he make it 3-0? Wow, a nod of acknowledgement from Peter Wright here. But is there a huge upset on the cards here in Hassel?
Well, that first down at double five was such a long way off. Almost 100. Didn't expect him to hit the double five, but what an adjustment that was. 3-0 to the Welshman.
And this would be a big upset, make no mistake.
It certainly would, Mr. Pike.
16.
Oh, the crowd massively supporting Peter Wright here in Hassel. Trying to get their man going.
He's going to have to get his head on pretty quickly.
100.
96. Average 11 scores of 100 or more, 3 out of 5 on 60. The doubles. I'd say that's pretty good.
Certainly, Stuart. Certainly is. Well above solid, I would say. Peter isn't.
55.
Real struggle here for Peter Wright, which is surprising.
And I'm sure at some point he will get his game going. How far will he be 80. Behind? Looking all and sundry like 4-0.
Well, those missed darts in the last leg could be absolutely crucial in the later stages of this match.
100.
Four missed darts at double for 2-1. And here, six darts for the Welshman to make it 4-0.
60.
Thought he might have gone for the 25 there with the last dart. To leave himself a two-darter. When you're ahead of a player, you don't want to give him anything. Give him a chance to get back in the game.
60. Johnny Clayton, 101.
Well, Peter Wright is just giving Johnny Clayton everything, isn't he? Double 16.
85.
Well, the treble 19 route here, 4-19s leaves the ball, 6-19s leaves double 6. He's going to get a shot at double 6 to get himself back in the match. He's missed a dart for 160, he's missed a dart for 126, and it's 4-0 down. Peter Wright 0. Johnny Clayton 4.
Oh, two beautiful darts in the treble 19. Again, it could be one of those situations where you're behind, you're thinking about being behind, you know you've got to get back into the match, you can't afford to miss this double. Pressure is rising.
83.
Clayton just going about his business, isn't he?
Yeah, solid, if not spectacular.
Doesn't have to be.
Well, early on in the match, he was hitting the double with the first dart. First two or three legs. Making sure that Peter Wright didn't have another visit to the ball.
For Peter Wright,
100.
Including 5 on the European Tour. The last 12 months, TV majors for Wright, sensational. World Championship, semi-final. European Champion Grand Slam semi-final in the second round.
For the next session, firing on all guns.
Clayton not thinking that, leaving a bogey number.
Oh, poor visit there.
54.
Remember the World Macro final against Phil Taylor. Taylor was excellent, but Wright missed double after double after double and chance after chance after chance. Is this a mirror image of that, I wonder?
131, Peter Crowe 20.
It's got to go.
Well, finally on the board, and that'll send him into the break a lot happier. He'll believe, and why not, that he can get back into this game. But at the moment, it's the Welshman, Johnny Clayton, who's dominating. The number two seed, Peter Wright, has it all to do. He trails 4-1. More darts on ITV4 next weekend, starting on Friday from the Brayhead Arena in Glasgow, the World Series Finals. And there are still tickets available. The Brayhead Arena, cracking tournament, will be a great weekend and a great venue. And we could be on for a great upset here. Johnny Clayton, who's qualified for the World Series Finals, is 4-1 up on Peter Wright. Peter Wright needs to start getting it right.
Well, it's certainly not the script that Peter Wright was expecting.
43.
To be fair, he hasn't really deserved it. He's got to get stuck in pretty quickly. They've had a break.
95.
Gather his thoughts, get himself ready for this second session. Can't afford to lose this session, Stuart. Well, even a 3-2 in his favour would be okay.
I'm sure he'd be looking to level it up 5-all. He wants a 4-1 session here. But no pressure. Clayton started this leg slowly, but Peter Wright, uncharacteristically, hasn't been able to make any gains, any real impression.
Well, his scoring hasn't been there. One maximum, two 140s. And we're in the sixth leg.
95.
A look of disdain on the face of Snakebite.
Clayton just plodding on.
Now then, this will be perfectly timed. There we go.
Welcome back, Mr. Wright.
Yeah, welcome to the party. To get a break back. With double 16. Well, there we go. That's what we're used to seeing. 14 darter.
251 in 5 darts. That will make him feel a little bit better.
Still too many flying into the fives for Peter Wright's liking, I'm sure. Well, these are going all right.
Well, the ferret gets his first maximum.
Is it the perfect response?
That's better. That's what we want to see. Good response again from Clayton. Good scoring leg from both players this one.
Needs the treble here.
16.
Oh dear, oh dear. Six darts from 181 for an immediate strike back for the ferret.
16.
Noticed on a few occasions as well, John, he's not used a 25-hole ball like a lot of players do. Could have possibly done it there, left 116. So may need to take out this 1-2-1. Or Peter Wright will claw another leg back.
Tops. Tops he needs. Score is wrong on the screen. Double 10. Oh!
Well,
Clayton needing 64 here. After Peter Wright misses three more darts and a double, this could be crucial! Oh dear! Fantastic for Clayton, disastrous for Wright! He was so far ahead.
Well, he won the first leg after the break, looked all and sundry like he was going to take that one. Done the hard work, and now he's made it harder.
Well, it should be 4-3. Clayton cashing in. Ka-ching, 5 out of 8 on the doubles. Peter Wright has missed 9 darts at double already.
It's not what you would expect from Snakebite. But it can happen. Clayton put him under pressure from the word go. 14 darts in the first leg. Went to a 4-0 lead.
81.
You know it's a longer distance, Stuart. The longer it goes on, he's behind, the harder it will be. Especially when Johnny Clayton is playing as well as this.
But the other thing that those misses in the last leg have done for Peter Wright is that it's visibly lifted Clayton again, hasn't it? Because it looked like being back-to-back legs, back to 4-3, Peter Wright turning it around. Clayton was a bit flat. Is he going to go for it?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. See the eyes.
But he's springing his step again, isn't he? After pitching the leg.
Well, he definitely didn't expect to be coming back to take the leg.
171.
Is it too little too late though, the 171? That's a perfect marker for him. Surely. Oh, well.
Clayton's turn to miss.
Yeah.
Is he returning the favour?
I suppose after the 171 he's earned the right. And he gets it right. So I think that's, you win some, you lose some. Leg 7, Wright misses 3, Clayton pinches it. Leg 8, Clayton misses 3, and Wright nicks it. All adds to the entertainment.
100.
The 171 was a beauty, wasn't it? Just put a bit of pressure, a little tap on the shoulder of Johnny Clayton.
Well, it worked in his favour on that occasion.
140.
Until then, Johnny Clayton's doubling has been pretty good. When you've got 3 darts in your hand, you almost expect to hit it.
A bit like Peter Wright here.
140.
Seemed to put his hands in the air before he threw the dart there. Back comes Clayton.
180.
Second one for him, the 5th in the match.
Not enough. Is it going to be another break of throw? 5 legs.
16.
Already won against the darts. You would think here a 140 is a minimum requirement for Peter Wright.
Well, he's just got to leave himself a doable finish.
I'll tell you what, after the first dart, they were terrific. They were impressive. As this is from the Welshman. Shave the wire. Now then, is this the most important visit of the match so far, I wonder?
Oh, the way they've been missing doubles, you can never tell. Well, is it the treble eight to leave tops? Double ten, doesn't want to be leaving Clayton another visit to the board.
3 out of 14 on the doubles. This would be a huge blow for Clayton.
Wow.
And the nerves starting to hit the Welshman.
Both players have been a double trouble, Stuart, in the last 10 minutes.
All adding to the drama. And Peter Wright gets back to within one. Somehow.
Well, as we know, Johnny Clayton, relatively inexperienced on TV darts. He's got to be thinking, I should be further ahead here. How will it affect him? Because Peter Wright will just keep doing what he's doing. He's got all the experience, all the recent wins behind him, as we know. He does go in at this break at 5 apiece. He will definitely be the happier of the two.
Wow, absolutely.
Remember, it was 4-0 down.
Clayton missed darts for 6-2. Missed darts for 6-3. Could find himself pegged back to 5 apiece. Why, we love the game.
16.
Not what he required, but he's still over 100 ahead. Before these three.
16.
Letting score and just letting him down at the vital moment here.
Yeah. Advantage right to level it up. Now levels up the 140 count, 8 apiece now.
Averaging up 95, 16. Almost 96 as well, when you think he was 88 after the first session.
And Clayton hasn't been able to hit a big treble in this leg.
Should stay up there, doesn't need to go for the 161. Right in the middle of the big nine. That'll do nicely.
He was thinking about it, wasn't he? Wasn't sure whether to leave 32 or 40.
Sometimes it's always good to keep away from your two darts, just in case.
Yeah.
For a level game. 13 darts at a break. Peter Wright was 4-1 down. He was 5-2 down. Should have been 6-2 down. Johnny Clayton will feel he has missed a big opportunity. Still all to play for in our final match of Saturday night at the European Championship. Wright and Clayton now level at 5 legs apiece. Roller coaster of emotions for the flamboyant Peter Wright here. Frustration, disappointment, delight, determination. And he's come from 4-1 down to level up at 5 apiece in the last match of the second round at the European Championship. First to 10 to go through to play Daryl Gurney in the quarterfinals on Sunday afternoon here in Hasselt in Belgium.
Well, it is a sign of a quality performer to drag yourself back in a match when you're not playing well. That's exactly what he's done. And now are starting to score. Hit two maximums in that last session. Another one there, that's his fourth. Back comes Clayton, no.
123.
All to play for.
A chance here for Clayton. Yeah, and the ferret nipping the ankles of Peter Wright here.
Smile on his face, and why not?
Peter Wright hasn't been ahead in this match at any stage.
Oh, he's after bogey as well, despite hitting treble 20 with the last dart.
100.
140 to leave 28 will be what he's looking at, I'm sure. Or will he go for the 16? No, he's gone for the 8, that's fine. To leave tops, had options, didn't he?
Thought he may have stayed on that treble 20 there, Stuart.
Yeah. It's a good life for him.
Certainly the angle of dart that he throws. Tops.
Had trouble on tops tonight. He's had trouble on double 10 as well tonight. He's had trouble on double 5.
I think it's fair to say he's on trouble on quite a few doubles. That's why he ended up 4-0 down.
Well, what a chance for Clayton. A real let-off for Peter Wright. Looking to go ahead for the first time.
Time to dig in. And dig in deep.
Well, there we have it. Johnny Clayton will be fuming. I'm sure the ferret will be fuming. He's lost four legs on the spin. And he's had eight darts to win three of them.
Yes, and when you look at the early part of the match, he was hitting the double with his first visit.
140.
Pressure.
Well, probably mad at himself because he's let the game slip. Let Peter Wright get back at him despite not really outscoring him that much. All of a sudden, from 4-0 up, 6-5 down. Mind. Be playing havoc with him.
100.
Gotta try and shake that off.
More frustration for Wright. Feels he should have done better there. Clayton's finding the target again, isn't he, on the treble 20?
23.
Well, they're both certainly scoring heavier. Certainly Peter Wright.
91. Johnny McCall, 138.
Trouble 19, another one of those. Peter Wright, top of the shop.
106, Peter Brown, 170.
There's himself, double 16. Good setup. This is the big one, but not to be.
130.
Just in case. Pressure on Clayton. He's been excellent, I have to say, on double 16. Ooh, now then, Johnny. Go, Johnny, go! Just.
Well, as you can see by the animation after hitting the double, and the earlier frustration, Stuart, but he got the job done there, just.
Did well under pressure. Peter Wright leaving himself on tops. Another miss from Clayton there, and another steal from Peter Wright. And you just wonder mentally where Clayton would have been if he'd have lost a fifth consecutive leg, but he didn't. We're level again.
Yes, that would have been hard to come back from. Only the bed to aim for. There we go. Number five. Five alive.
140.
We talked about Wright missing on tops. Here's one for you. He's had 8 attempts at tops and missed the lot tonight.
140.
Normally his favourite as well.
Yeah. Lords out of 8 on tops.
He's got a good leg here though. 81 after 9.
81. 81.
So if he doesn't hit the treble 19, doesn't need to go for 12 ball. So treble 10, double 16. There we go.
65.
6 out of 21 on the doubles for both now.
This game just needs one of the players to really take it by the scruff of the neck. Peter Wright chipping away. Now leads 7-6.
Enjoying this, and I think that all the doubling dramas and the missing is sort of adding to it, isn't it?
Yes, because of both doing it.
Yeah.
Both had periods in the match where they've scored heavy and missed doubles, or not scored and taken out the double first dart. A strange old game. That's why we love it.
The 43-year-old Welshman is still very much in this.
Number 4. 9 in the match so far. Clayton looking to level again at 7 apiece. He's keeping in there, that's the main thing. You felt for him really after leg 11 when he went behind. He's managed to keep his composure, dig in there. Not number 6. Right now. Treble for double.
60.
Well, that potentially would have been an 11 darter for him.
Yeah, good scoring leg. Just needs to tidy it up now. Peter Wright just over his shoulder now. Despite being a long way behind before that visit. One dart left. Oh, good dart.
The last two legs he's won with last dart in his hand, with Peter Wright poised.
There you can see. Yeah, certainly was, Stuart. Anything can happen. Getting closer to the winning line. Getting that sequence where whoever's throwing first is winning the leg, which never seemed likely earlier on in the match.
10 in the game now.
Just a nice setup here. It's a treble, may go for the ball for the last one, possibly. At least 76.
Good call. Anyone would think you played this game.
Well, we can't leave a finish plate in here. He's just going to try and keep the rhythm going. Well, tops, Stuart. Will he hit it?
Naught out of 9. On tops.
That's a long way off that one.
He's going to be under pressure here.
He is.
Clayton leaving tops. Well, this 40. big moments in this game. Naught out of 10 on tops. Naught out of 11 on tops. Naught out of 12 on tops.
Well, said a few visits ago, Stuart, Peter Wright was so far in front, he left himself 76. Clayton was on 3-2-0. Back-to-back 140s, Peter Wright missing tops again.
four darts. No, shaking his head behind, but you know, he had options to leave another double. Perhaps 81. He'll stay clear of tops, but that's an astonishing stat. 12 darts at tops, he's missed them all. And those misses may well see Peter Wright sensationally beaten here in Hasselt by the total outsider, the qualifier, the man who squeezed in on countback at the European Championship, Johnny Clayton.
Well, he's trying to gather his thoughts. Knows he needs to dig in here and produce his best.
Yeah, trying to put it out of his mind. He knows he should be 8-7 up. And on his way, possibly, to the quarter-finals, because the destiny of the match was in his own hands. It isn't anymore. It's in the hands of his opponent.
Well, there's not much in the leg here, so still some work to do. Can afford any mistakes, and that's one from Clayton. Peter Wright normally feeds off mistakes like that, but he's not doing at the moment. Good last one, though. Good last one. Well, that's two in.
140.
Leaves himself for finish. Again, Peter Wright trailing in the leg. Needs a full house. I feel a ton, probably not enough, Stuart.
100. Johnny Rapal, 158.
Well, that 15th leg could be the pivotal moment in this match, because it could cost Peter Wright. It could send Johnny Clayton on the way to the biggest win of his career.
Well, that was a strange way to go for Johnny Clayton. Unless he completely miscounted. 158 and he offered treble 19.
98. Johnny requires 60.
And he hit it. The immaterial if he can get this. One more. Ooh. He's let Peter Wright off here. He really has. Made a bit of a mess there. Maybe just lost his concentration.
Well, surely he's not going to go six for tops. Biggest dart of the match coming up now. Clayton had two for 9-7. And Wright, well, he's played a few get-out-of-jail-free cards tonight, Peter Wright. I didn't know there was that many in the pack.
Oh, both players must be getting close to being mentally drained as Peter Wright hits a magnificent 7! Maximums.
60.
Is it going to be a bitter, sweet European experience for Johnny Clayton as Peter Wright, who has never hit a 9-darter in a TV major?
Well, his scoring has been good. His doubling hasn't. Let's hope he doesn't leave tops.
Here we go. Peter Wright. Got to keep focused here, keep the concentration.
Johnny Clayton a long, long way behind, leaving two maximums in the next two visits.
16.
Still have to return to the board, so 96 for Wright.
For an 11 dart leg.
Well, it's been a mixed bag all the way through this encounter.
It deserves to go to a last leg decider, I reckon.
I can't argue with that. Can't argue with that. We had one in our first game of this evening. Michael Smith edging out Benito van der Pass.
Fantastic.
125.
Disappointment again. The first two were so well positioned for him. This is a good recovery from Clayton.
85.
Not the best visit or the worst. But it only puts him 40 ahead. And that's soon being negated.
And he lifts the dart over.
100.
Too much over.
That's a good one. Oh, lovely from Clayton. Lovely from Clayton. Another maximum from the Welshman. He wants it to go to the last leg. So does the crowd. Don't think Peter Wright does, though.
140,
getting tense.
Ooh, bit of a slip there. Would it cost him?
Well, this would be some way to win. But despite missing 20 darts at double, you know, he's still averaging just shy of 100, Peter Wright.
Incredible. This will be an incredible finish. This will be incredible. Not quite the anguish in the crowd. Now then, Clayton has to hit this. 18 for Tops. Tops to save it!
45.
Wow. All the fun of the fair. The drama, the excitement, the tension. Will it be the victory for Peter Wright? Well, he knows he has been pushed all the way. Johnny Clayton came so close to what would have been the biggest win of his career. But experience wins the day. He knows. Look at the face. He's got away with one. And Peter Wright goes through to the European Championship quarterfinals. A relieved man to take on Daryl Gurney on Sunday afternoon. Terrific effort from Johnny Clayton. He just came up short, and the dream is alive for Peter Wright.
An experienced Scotsman has beaten a rather less experienced Welshman to reach the quarterfinals of the European Championship darts here in Belgium. Peter Wright beating Johnny Clayton 10-8, having come back from 4-0 down. Well, those are the stats, a case of missed opportunities from Johnny Clayton. 22 missed darts at double for him, and that really cost him at the end. Peter Wright hasn't necessarily been on top form in the last few weeks, although he did win the German Masters recently. We'll talk about that in just a moment. Well, let's have a look at how things stand. There's the quarterfinals lineup for you. We knew that Michael van Gogh would be playing Simon Whitlock tomorrow. Kyle Anderson meeting Mensur Sulevic. And tonight, we've discovered that the final two quarterfinals will be Peter Wright against Daryl Gurney. Wow, that should be a good one. And also Rob Cross against Michael Smith. What a year Rob Cross is having. And both Peter Wright and Johnny Clayton downstairs talking to Dan Dawson.
Gentlemen, it was one heck of a game to finish the night. Peter, somehow you've got the job done, but you had to dig deep.
Obviously, the outfit obviously it explains it all. You know, cats get nine lives. I think I definitely used all them up against Johnny. You know. It was just, I don't know, we was both battling, like missing doubles in the first half, first set. Well, not first set, but the first session. I missed doubles and then Johnny punished me, and then obviously the next session he done exactly the same. He missed doubles, I punished him, and it was like a game of, I don't know, it went darts, it was like table tennis or tennis, I don't know, I can't explain it, it's horrible.
Johnny, I know it's very disappointing, thanks for coming and speaking to us. It's got to be an agonising one, hasn't it? It's come so close.
Yeah, it is. Obviously, had my chances on doubles, didn't take, and at the end of the day, when you play the quality of Peter and the top players, you've got to take those chances, and I just didn't take them.
Very close to making the quarterfinals of this tournament for the first time, but it's been a fantastic few months for you, Johnny. Picking up your first PDC title, we will be seeing it at the World Series finals as well. This is real progress.
Oh, yeah, definitely. But I'm always disappointed. You know, it was just that little step closer to something bigger. So, yeah, disappointed, yeah.
Peter, you've still averaged 99 there, despite the fact you're unable to hit double top through the entirety of the game. If that clicks, then people had better watch out.
Well, and obviously, you got to remember all the doubles Johnny missed, and he's played fantastic the last month and a half, and I think to get yourself here, winning the players' championships and beating everybody, he can beat anybody in the world, and he should have done it to me, and I was very lucky. Sorry to his kiddies, because they love me and they love Dad. Yeah. Sorry, kids. Sorry.
Well, thanks, gents. A fantastic game to round it off. Congratulations, Peter. Commiserations. Well played, Johnny.
Thank you.
Toby, get well.
Oh, the fans here absolutely love Peter Wright. When I nipped up to the ladies earlier, right next to the gents, all I could hear was a chanting of Peter, Peter Wright. They absolutely love him. And he is safely... Well, yeah, you have to pay 50 pence a go here, actually. 50 cents every time you want to go. It can be quite an expensive business. And that's the lineup. That's what we saw tonight. It was a while ago now that we saw Michael Smith.